Good morning, dear students. Now we will come back to another video on short stature. Short stature is a very important topic. You have to understand the concepts and then only you will be able to write it properly. So first thing is we have to know the definition, then type. So what is this width and height and so many things. So please pay attention. First thing is definition. So what is meant by a short stature? Short stature is defined as height of a child less than third percentile or less than minus 2 standard deviation according to the age and sex of the child. So I repeat, definition is height of the child less than third percentile or less than minus 2 standard deviation of expected according to the age and sex of the child. We have two types, that is, one is proportionate short stature, another one is disproportionate short stature. Proportionate short stature means the ratio. I already told in my previous video, upper segment, lower segment ratio is maintained. That means it is unchanged. That is the proportionate short stature. Another thing is disproportionate short stature, where the upper segment, lower segment ratio is altered. Okay, these are the two types of things. So we have to write this proportionate, where the upper segment, lower segment ratio is maintained, and disproportionate when the upper segment, lower segment ratio is altered. Okay, now certain terminologies you have to know to understand the concept. One is the growth charts, which we already told, the age will be here, height will be here. We can use a centile chart or we can use a standard deviation chart, wherever it is. So any child whose height is less than, suppose the height is here, less than the third percentile or less than minus 2 standard deviation, that is taken to be short stature here. Okay. Now, what is this mid-parental height? Mid-parental height is father's height plus mother's height plus 13 divided by 2 for boys, father's height plus mother's height minus 13 divided by 2 for girls. So that is the mid-parental height. Always target height is on mid-parental height is plotted at 18 years. Suppose coming to the types of proportionate short stature, we will learn in detail about proportionate short stature first. There are different varieties. One is normal variant. Okay. Then we have intrauterine problem. Causes can be many. We can have acquired causes or postnatal causes. So causes, they can be a normal variant or intrauterine causes or acquired or postnatal causes. The normal variant, that's why I'm writing in red. We have mainly two types, familial short stature and constitutional delay of growth and puberty. This is a short question in most of the exams, that is familial short stature and CDGP, that is constitutional delay in growth and puberty. Before going into this in detail, we'll just discuss a few causes of intrauterine. Intrauterine causes of proportionate short stature, you can say about IUGR, in utero infections. Any in utero infection will cause intrauterine growth, the height will be, or length will be restricted. And certain genetic syndromes like Turner syndrome, Down syndrome, Sickle syndrome, etc. So many things. So intrauterine can be intrauterine infections, intrauterine growth syndromes, IUGRs, etc. What are the acquired causes or postnatal causes of proportionate short stature? The one and the major thing has to be malnutrition. Some chronic systemic diseases. It can be anything. It can be a chronic kidney disease or a chronic liver disease, etc. It can be a malabsorption. Malabsorption, that means like something like a celiac syndrome, celiac disease. It can be an endocrine disorders where the short stature will be small, like a growth hormone deficiency or a Cushing syndrome, etc. Or it can be even psychosocial, like maternal depression, socioeconomic disease. All those things will come under psychosocial causes of baby short stature. So we have normal variants, we have intrauterine causes, and we also have acquired causes. Major will be malnutrition, the systemic diseases, malabsorption syndromes like celiac disease. We have endocrine disorders like GH deficiency, Cushing syndromes. We have psychosocial dwarfism or psychosocial causes like maternal deprivation or maternal depression. Now we will go in detail about FSS and CDGP. We'll maintain this growth chart here for ease of understanding, okay? So we have two categories now. We have familial short stature, we have constitutional delay of growth and puberty. Familial short stature, I always tell my students, just remember the parents are short, the child is also short, adult height is also short. So a small bond, parents are so short, as a childhood child is short, and an adult also child is in the short stature or child is short. And why they are called normal variants? Because they actually are in their target height range. So in familial short stature, they are, these two are the normal variants of proportional short stature, because they both, though they are short, they are in the final, they are in the same trajectory as their final target height. So as per her target height, a child is normal. So familial short stature, remember the child's height is less than third percentile or less than 2 standard deviation, but as per the target height, it is child is normal. So height less than third percentile or minus 2 standard deviation, but normal according to target height. Very, very important. The child is normal according to the target height. Here what happens? In constitutional delay of growth and puberty, again, the child, though the birth length height, etc., okay, the child is short in the childhood, but at the time of puberty, the child's growth spurt increases and the target height is again normal. So, childhood, the height is less than third percentile or less than minus 2 standard deviation, but height is normal as an adult. So final, or I can say the child's height is, younger height is less, but adult height is normal. So this is a major thing we have to know about familial short stature. Another thing here, definitely you will get a family history of short stature in the parents. Whereas here you get a family history of delayed puberty in the parents. And his mother will say they give you a history of delayed menarche. Okay? So our father will have a history of delayed puberty. So whatever it is, the baby will give you the family, there will be a family history of delayed puberty there. Here the puberty is, child's puberty is normal, okay? Here we have a delayed puberty in this case. Okay. Then another thing is about, one main thing we should understand is about the bone age. Always frequently as MCQ is on bone age. What is bone age? What is chronological age? And what is height age? So here we should know that I told you what is the height at 4 years of age. So it is 100 centimeters. So at 100 centimeters, if a 4-year-old child expected is 100 centimeters. Suppose we have a baby, 4-year baby only, but having a height of around only 87. So 87 is the height for 2-year-old child. So though the chronological age of the child is 4 years, the baby's height age of 87 is corresponding to a, that means height age is only 2 years. So this, I think you have to understand the concepts of height age, chronological age. Chronological age, what is the correct age of the child, and bone age of the child. Bone age you have to estimate by taking various radiographs. For example, very small babies means you see the x-ray, some bigger child up to 13 years, it's better you can use the wrist because all the carpal bones ossification we can find it out and get you the bone age. Here in FSS the skeletal maturation is normal, so bone age will be equal to the chronological age, whereas in CDGP the bone age is delayed, so bone age less than chronological age. So these points we have to know very clearly. In FSS the bone age will be equal to chronological age. So this is a little bit out of the thing, but it's better if you can write it this here. The bone age will be equal to chronological age, but both will be less than the
കാണുന്നില്ല ഈക്വൽ ടു അല്ല താഴത്തെ ഏറ്റവും ലാസ്റ്റ് ബി ആൻഡ് സി.
So this much I hope you understood that between the bone age, there is no this, just remember this, no. Or I can just remember, like, skeletal maturation is normal. Here the skeletal maturation is delayed. So that is why in a case of familiar short seizures, the bone age will correspond to the chronological age, whereas in a CDGP the bone age will be less than the chronological age. That means suppose a child is 4 years, you will get a bone age of around maybe 3 years or 2 years according to the graph of it. Okay, in both cases growth velocity, what will happen to the growth velocity? The growth velocity will be normal in both cases of CDGP and the FSS, and meaning both, in both cases growth length, height, everything will be normal. Okay, so these two concepts very should be very clear. So in familial short seizure the baby will be born short, will grow short, and also the adult height also will be short. In CDGP the baby will be short in childhood, but adult height will be normal. They may have a history of delayed puberty. Main thing, don't forget that skeletal maturation is normal in familial short seizure, so bone age and chronological age matches, whereas bone age will be delayed or less than the chronological age in CDGP. Okay, both cases will have normal growth velocity. So if you can understand this, I think this was another question which is frequently asked always, so this should be very clear. So if somebody asks you what happens in FSS, you should be able to say the bone age will be equal to chronological age. Okay, and if somebody asks you what happened to CDGP or constant delay in growth and puberty, you should be able to say the bone age will be less than the chronological age. Okay, here in FSS the bone age and chronological age matches. So but definitely this will be both, height age will be less than both of this. Okay, and CDGP, here the bone age and height age will match. You can write it here. This is just out of the question. Just I'll let you know about this. If you don't understand, it's okay. But then for BGN, it will be good because you should understand in FSS. Basic concept is this. FSS, the basic concept. In CDGP, the basic concept is this. Height age and bone age. Here, the bone age and this will correspond. The height age will be less. Here, bone age and height age will correspond. Whereas, it will be less than the chronological age. Okay. Now, coming to the causes of disproportionate short stature. Coming to the causes of disproportionate short seizure. Disproportionate means, I told you that upper segment lower segment ratio is altered. Okay, what is the upper segment lower segment ratio at birth? It is 1.7 to 1.9 at birth. 3 years, 1.3:1, and at 7 to 10 years, it is 1:1. So we have two causes. One, we have a short trunk dwarfism. Here we have a short limbed organism. Upper segment, lower segment ratio. Trunk is short. So upper segment, so what is that? Upper segment, lower segment, what happened? The reverse is less. So this will be decreased. Whereas in short limb, upper segment, lower segment ratio, short limb. Limb is very short. So this will be increased. Okay. So coming to the causes of, again, causes of short trunk dwarfism. We have so many causes. So the trunk is short. We have so hemivertebrae. We have caries pain. We have mucopolysaccharidosis, mucolipidosis, spondyloepiphyseal dysplasias, and also hem. This spondyloepiphyseal means spondyl means the vertebrae. So this is short trunk. So there was a mnemonic for that, and that is short man. A climb high. S for spondylo epiphyseal dysplasias. M for mucopolysaccharidosis. M for mucolipidosis. C for caries spine, and H for hemivertebrae. Another thing is about short limb dwarfism. We have so many causes. Coming to the short limb itself, I repeat, rickets, achondroplasia, osteogenesis imperfecta, hypothyroidism, so many things like chondrodysplasia punctata, hemichondroplasias, etc., or hypochondroplasias, metaphyseal chondrodysplasia punctata, etc. So I hope in this class you would have understood in short about the causes of short stature. Is a go, and we have to find out the, get to the, understand the concept behind it, then only we'll be able to write the definition and also regarding the types and other things. Okay, so please prepare the short notes on this. Keep reading and stay safe in this period. Thank you so much.